This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Once it's come, then till that time we can able to go for ice kasi. Is the one of the another snow racing. Okay. Yesterday we saw that DFC, right? Now we are just going for another storage. It's ice kasi. Okay. Ice kasi stands for small computer system interface. Okay. SCSI means small computer system interface. Okay. So now what is the same thing? This is the hard disk combined with one LAN, and we just got storage processor A and storage processor B. From there it will be connected to the IP network. Instead of fabric search, we will be using the IP network, and then we'll be having one host as HP card, one as a software ISKC. There are two different method we can able to connect the storage. Okay. So you got it right. Yesterday I sent this PPT to you. Have you got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So go through that. So if in case of if you are facing any issue or something, let me know. Okay. There are two things. One is they will be making a target name and initiator name. Okay. One more thing I just forgot to tell, that in fiber channel we will be using WWN. Actually, it's once you insert the HP card, right? So we always have the WWN. Okay, WWPN. There are two things. Okay, WWN is nothing but the worldwide name. Okay. WWPN is world number, port number. This is the two things it will be come across. I just show you. Yeah, this is the thing. Okay, this need to be given to the storage team. Okay, whenever you just facing the issue, okay, you don't have the space or something, you just need to give that HPA card of that particular WWN, and they will be checking in that storage switch. Okay, switch end. Okay, when they will be allocating the LAN of that particular cluster, and it will be visible to you when you rescan that. Okay. That HPA card. This is how the method they will be going for. Okay. So now here nice kasi we'll be using, instead of WWN, we'll be using IQN. That's a difference. ISKC qualify name. IQN means ISKC qualify name. This is how they will be stands for. And they will be, if www.hcl.com means it will be backend.com.hcl.wwn. Sorry, www. This is how this will be stands for. You can able to see this here itself. You can able to see, right? It will be in the reverse order, not in the standard order. Okay. So the target name, it always will be the storage processor. The storage, they will be having the one target. Initiator, we need to initiate in the host end. Okay. That we are going to do that. Okay. In the practical now, how to initiate that one, how to create a LAN, how to mount the LAN in the host. Okay. So there are three types of initiator I told. One is software, one is dependent hardware and independent hardware ISKC. See, one is HP card. Okay. One is HP card need to be inserted, and from that we can able to do that one. Okay. One is software ISKC. That only we are going to do now. So how to initiate that one, how to create that, all the stuff. Okay. Dependent means that is, this is also one of the ISKC initiator. Okay, the NIC, to the NIC we can able to attach it.
Hold on a second. What was it?
So the software ISKC is nothing but we need to initiate in the software, okay, in the storage, and target will be the, say, target will be the storage and initiator will be our end. Okay, this is the software. Independent order means the HPA card should be inserted in that particular order. Okay, that is the independent order ISKC. This method, you got it?
Okay.
Another thing, the particular rows, if you want to use ISKC permanently, then you have to order that I will be using the ISKC. Just give me ISKC port in that particular server. That is dependent order. That is one of the NIC it will be attached while coming into the server itself. Okay, these are three types it will be available. So if you want which one, you can able to suggest. Because nowadays they are not using the ISKC. Okay, if they want, they will go for NAS or fiber channel.
Okay.
So now we are going for that practical. I'll show you how it will be connected. Okay. So one of the how to connect me, we don't have the storage actually. Okay. We just having third party tool called OpenFiler. Okay. I'll show you. I just give this software to you. Okay. I just upload in the Google Drive. You just download. Okay.
Okay.
The open file is one of the thing. It will be connected as a storage. Okay, we can able to make it as a for a NFS and for the ISKC. Both the thing we can able to do. Okay. So file, just create a new virtual machine. Nest. The
go back. What did you select?
Same custom. Thing, custom. Custom. Only custom. Okay. I just said it. Okay. This nest, the version is 12, and here we need to choose that open file. Okay, the version is 2.99. That is the version. Okay, just click OK, and click next. Here we need to select Linux. And make it as Red Hat Linux 5. Don't select apart from 5. Okay, it will be create SAR file, some other things. So it will be complicated. Okay. So we are just making it as run. Okay. And browse. Okay, I just putting at run. Okay. Already I created a folder. Next, one browser. RAM is 1 GB, it's enough for you. Okay, go for bridge network. Same thing, that is no different. Only two difference, one is Linux we have to select.
Hold on. All right, go back a few screen. One processor.
Okay. Same. We are just, in the ESS host, we will be giving two browser, right? Now we are using only one. That's enough. Okay. 1 GB of RAM, it's enough. That also is 1 GB, it's enough.
Okay.
Okay, shall we go?
Yep.
So use bridge network actually. Okay. Then SCSI is already, you know, right? This is a adapter we'll be using. Virtual disk type is SCSI always. We never use a setup. So create a new virtual disk as 10 GB for OS alone. Okay. We are not going for any LAN or something. We are just giving for only the OS. Okay.
OS.
Now we are
okay.
going for installing. Browse lab and make it as your thing and save.
Mm-hmm.
Next and finish. This is how the screen will be there. Just enter it. It's fully Linux, okay? Okay, open filer. Okay, just click next and select US English. Okay, always this is the default one. So here the partition table or device SDA was unreachable. To create a new partition, we need to do the we have to create a partition, right? So it's already there. So we need to give yes. Okay, if you give no, it will not be initialized. So now we are just formatting the disk like that. Okay. Okay, again it will show this thing. Just click next and it will again ask for the confirmation. Okay, click yes, nothing need to be do. So here we need to give the IP address actually. Okay, we have to give the IP. So I just want to check that IP address.
On my VM, I can create the VM, but I cannot start it. For some reason, the disk space is, I'm having an issue with the space or something, the way I configure it. So none of my VM.
Why, what happened? You just got full or something? The laptop
no, I don't know. No, I don't think it's a full, but I think I might have misconfigured something.
Let me check. Okay, once we done this thing, we just share the screen and let me know where it's got fail or something. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, 10:32 we are just gone. Now we are just go for
manual.
10:10:10:134. I just go 134. Okay. 2:0.0.0. I just disable the IP version 6. Just click OK and enable this before. If you are not enabled, then it will be complicated. Again, we need to go into that. And we need to enable, but it's a Linux, so we need to know the command, all the stuff. Okay. So the gateway we have to mention. Okay. So click on next. It will ask for the DNS. So just click on continue. That is not an issue. So we need to select the region actually. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's Calcutta, okay? It will show the Calcutta one. And we have to give the password for this entering, okay? Next and next, it will be installing now.
So this device will work as a unified storage.
Correct. So we don't have the storage, right? We cannot be able to have it in the lab or something. So. So reboot us, it will be reboot. Okay, now it's installed. I am going to shut down, okay, because I need to add the LAN, right? So we don't have the hard disk, correct? So again, we need to create one more 30 GB hard disk, okay? For that, I just go to edit settings.
Hold on, let me run it now.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Just click on this.
And you
add.
Are touching another drive. Okay. Add.
Hard disk. SCSI. Create a new disk as 30 GB. Store virtual disk as a single file. Okay. And finish. Just click OK. And power on that particular machine. Okay, it's came now. So go to vCenter. And we need to open the open file to Google Chrome. Okay, in this. So I just going for settings and option and shared, because I just kept in that software as a in local drive. Okay, so
okay,
I just want to copy.
What are you copying? Under
this thing, I need to copy because I don't have that Google Chrome, right? This software is not available, correct? So for that, I need to copy it from the local drive to that particular machine. Okay.
Okay.
So for that, I just going to enable that one. How to do that, means so you can copy any software, not like the I just talking
just,
about only the Google. So this Google Chrome setup, I have to copy to that particular vCenter machine. Okay. Any software you need to copy means right click, edit, okay, and go to this option.
Right. Okay. Edit options. Yep. And share folder.
Okay, share folder and click enable. Just add and click on next. Need to browse which folder you have to copy. Okay, I just have ISO G drive. Okay, this is only I just have the software. Okay, so click on this. Just click next and it will ask for the enable the share. If you want to only the read
from the host to the VM, you're doing it right?
Not host. I just talking about the local host.
Local host, right?
Yeah. Okay. So click on finish. Okay. Now just click OK. Go to Explorer. And go to network. It will ask for the network discovery to be turned on. Okay, just click on that. It will be turned on that. So again, you refresh it. It will the local host. It will be mapped to that particular VM machine.
Yeah.
Okay. Just click on this. Double click. software. I just copying that Google Chrome to my local vCenter
computer.
Machine. Just double click, it will be installed. Yeah, now it's done. So click on next and open this Google Chrome. Now it's open. Now I just want to type that URL, okay, which was configured. Learn, we have done it, right? So 10.2.10.10.134, 446 is a port actually, okay? Once you click on that, this is the thing, okay? Proceed. This is how the page will be look like, okay? So username will be the open file as the default one. It will not be never be changed, okay? Password is the password. There is no captcha or nothing. Only the password means password. Okay. I just click OK, login. You will be getting the screen. Okay. So go to volume.
Okay.
Just note it down one by one. Okay. So create new physical volume. This is the one option it will be shown, right? So click on that.
Okay. Got it.
It take time.
Oh.
Yeah. You can able to see the two orders which was added to that particular thing. One is 10 GB which is given for OS and 30 GB we have just after that we shut down and we added, right? 30 GB. Okay, click on that dev SDB 30 GB. No need to go for 10 GB, okay? Just click on that. You will be getting the screen. Okay. Like as a SETA cylinder, you know, right? The hard disk, how it will be look like. So just click on that particular create button. That's it. Nothing need to do here.
Okay.
Once you're done, just go to volume group, this option. Okay, we are just grouping now. So what is the grouping? Storage, any name you are just give. Okay, just click on that particular hard disk. Okay, just add volume group.
Hold on. Okay, yeah, storage LAN, your name.
I just give you storage, whatever you want. I know it's up to you. Just click add volume group.
Okay. Okay.
Once you're done, just go to add volume. Okay. This option. into now 30 GB we have provision, right? In that how much we are going to give, okay? I'm just giving as Windows, okay? I'm just going for Windows, and we are just using the 30 GB of space, okay?
Okay.
And make it that file system as block, iSCSI, I told, right? This option you have to select, iSCSI fiber channel, okay? This is a block, correct? So we need to use the block here, okay? Just click on that create. Now the hard disk has been initialized, okay? You got it right till now?
Yeah, do you have an instruction how to do this?
No, I just telling you, right? One time if you see and do that, then it will be easy for you. That's why I just tell always to write it down the steps how to do
yeah
that.
I did, but it'd be nice for somebody. Okay, that's fine.
I just shared this video, don't worry. Today once it's done, so just download it and note it down how to make it, okay?
Yeah, but the thing is, my thing is not working, so I cannot get it anything install or cannot do anything test.
No,
or
once it's done, right? So we'll check on that. Surely we'll make it ready. Okay. So I go to services. Okay. Just go to iSCSI. There are two things. iSCSI, I told, right? Initiator and
right.
target. Correct. So that need to be enabled. Okay, now this has been done, correct? Now go to volume, go to iSCSI target. This is the one of the option it will be shown, okay? Just click on that iSCSI target. Just click add, nothing need to do, okay? Just click add, it will go for the iSCSI target. Okay, this is the target, and these are the settings, IQN, I told, right? This is the target, okay? Just click update, nothing need to do, okay? Then after that, once it's done, then go to LAN masking, sorry, LAN mapping. This LAN need to be mapped to that particular any host, okay? So click on that mapping option, that's it. Now we just created the what LAN, okay? Just minimize it and go to VMware. This is a step you are going to do in the real time, actually, not apart from that anything. Okay, now just click on that particular host, go to configuration, and go
okay,
to storage adapter. Okay.
Right, yep, and block
add software
and
execution. Okay, just click on that particular thing. Once it's added, so click on OK. Now the HPA card is assigned. Okay,
what was the can you click on again that add and
no, it
was,
did not be because
right,
they
just
want
click. Oh, there is nothing you cannot click anymore because
no,
there is no
because at one time that's a problem. So nothing, just click on host configuration and storage adapter, just click on add. It will show two option. Okay, one is authorized SCSI and SCOE. Okay, so just click
what
on
was that
that
two option was it iSCSI was it
iSCSI and SCOE.
SEO,
fiber
okay.
Channel, yeah, fiber channel over Ethernet.
Okay.
Okay, just click on iSCSI, then it will this option it will be enabled. Click OK, then it will be option it will be enabled. Okay. Now click on that this thing HPA card and go to properties and dynamic discovery. This is the option you have to go to select. Okay.
Oh, can you slow down a little bit? Go back
yeah.
Where you went. I don't
go
know
on.
Where you went.
Just properties.
Double
here.
Click on a.
No double click. This is a just click on that.
Oh.
It will ask for the general network configuration, dynamic discovery. This is the option you have to select. Click on that option, and click add. And we need to give that particular IP address. What IP? 134. Correct. This is a default port. No need to change here. Okay.
Can you
just
hold on?
Click.
Hold on.
Yeah.
I got so much going on. you're all good.
$500 flat. I've done. Yeah. Before.
Sorry about that.
No problem.
So you just click on add send. Okay. IP and a port.
Yeah, we need to give that IP. Port is the default one. Nothing need to be changed.
What
okay.
was 3260?
3250? 3260 is the default. Okay, nothing need to be changed.
Okay.
Just click OK.
Mm-hmm.
So it will be shown here, and starting also it will automatically it will be there. So you can able to identify 191922. This is the information, it will be shown here. Correct? You got it? 1922.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just for cast verifying, I just giving it. Okay, how to check on that? Just close it. And it lost for the rescan. Okay, the rescan of the host adapter is recommended. Okay, just click yes. Nothing need to be do. So now you can able to see 111. Correct? You can able to see, right?
Okay.
Once you click on that rescan, it will be shown as 111, and you can able to see the VMHPA. Okay, the card. Okay. So yesterday I told, right, runtime name. You found that this is the thing. Runtime name is VMHPA, number, channel, target and LAN. Okay. So now just go to storage, just click on add and disk
add
and LAN
storage. Hold on.
Yeah,
now you need to write it down. Okay, going back to storage,
only storage. Okay, I didn't do anything.
Right. Yeah, and then add storage.
Add storage, just click on disk and LAN.
Okay.
Just click on next. It will be shown as that 30 GB, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just click on that. Just click next.
Yeah.
Just click on next again.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to give the name of that LAN.
Data store.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Data store or something. Okay. Just click on next. So how much you are going to use? I just use the maximize. Okay. Maximize 30 GB. This is going to be used 30 GB. Click and finish. Now the LAN will be mounted here. Okay, now its LAN is mounted. Okay, nothing need to be do. Just click on that. I told right yesterday the path, three path storage policy path, I told right, fixed, round robin and MRU. So defaultly it will be have the fixed. Yeah. So go to properties. Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, nothing. Just click on that particular LAN and it will go to properties. I did never do anything.
Yeah.
You can rename that data store. Okay, whatever the thing. So the if you want to increase the data store size, just click on increase. It will again it will show the what of the LAN is available. You can able to increase that particular thing. Okay. So the file says what is the VMFS file version 5.61. Maximum how much we can able to do means 2 TB. And what is a block? Okay, I told right 1 MB block size.
Yeah.
If you want to change that policy from fixed to round robin, okay, if you want to do, just go to manage path. You bottom is the right manage path, correct? Just click on that, it will be shown that these are the three options.
Hold on, okay. So that's where you went on a properties?
Yeah, I just gone to properties. No, not properties. Here it is. Manage path.
Manage path.
That's it. Here you can able to see this thing.
Okay.
So well, that's it. We just completed the how to create the LAN. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I just share you this thing recording. Okay. Just try. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then only you can, because tomorrow we will go for the NFS, right? Same yeah. step, but some of the thing it will be different.
Different.
Yeah. Option will be different. Same thing. We mm-hmm. are just going for this NFS. Mm-hmm. Actually mm-hmm. okay, just mm-hmm. share your screen so that I can able to find it out what is the issue.
Let me see, hold on, see if I can down.